Dear students, myself L. Jetru Timalda Meri, Assistant Professor in Mathematics, St. Joseph College of Arts and Science, Autonomous, Kadalur, Tamil Nadu. I proudly present this video for first year MSc Mathematics students in Mathematical Programming. The title is Solving Integer Linear Programming Problem. We know that in a linear programming problem, all decision variables may assume either integer value or non-integer value. Linear programming problems are solved by different methods such as graphical method, simplex method, bigger method, two-phase method, dual simplex method, and revised simplex method. In a linear programming problem, if the optimal solution is an integer solution, then it is called an integer linear programming problem. The integer linear programming problem is divided into three types. They are pure integer programming problem, mixed integer programming problem, and 0-1 integer programming problem. What is called pure integer programming problem? In an integer linear programming problem, if all decision variables are assigned only integer solution, then it is called pure integer or all integer programming problem. It is solved by using Gomery's cutting plane method or branch and bound method. In mixed integer linear programming problem, the restricted variables are allowed to take integer solution, whereas in 0-1 integer programming problem, all decision variables are restricted to take either 0 or 1. Gomery's cutting plane method. In this method, all integer or pure integer linear programming problems are solved. The following are the procedure to solve pure integer programming problem. Step 1. Convert the given integer programming problem into standard form. Step 2. After converting into standard form, it is solved using simplex method by ignoring the integer requirement. Step 3. In an optimal simplex table, if one or more decision variables assigned non-integer values, then go to step 4. Otherwise, the current solution is an optimal solution. Step 4. Choose the chosen row which has the largest fractional value in XB column of the optimal simplex table, and then generate a cut which is called Gomery's cut. Step 5. Add this Gomery's cut or constraint to the bottom of the optimal simplex table and solve by using dual simplex method. Step 6. If all decision variables assigned only integer solution, then stop the procedure. The additional constraint, namely it is called Gomery's cut or new constraint, which is generated from the source row chosen from the optimal simplex table. The slack variable of the additional constraint is called Gomery's slack variable, and it is denoted by SG. Now we are going to solve all integer linear programming problem using Gomery's cutting plane method. The problem is maximize z equal to x1 plus x2 subject to the constraints 3x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 5 and x2 less than or equal to 2, where x1 comma x2 greater than or equal to 0 and are integers. The given problem is solved by using simplex method by ignoring the integer requirement. The standard form of the integer linear programming problem is maximize z equal to x1 plus x2 subject to the constraints 3x1 plus 2x2 plus s1 equal to 5, x2 plus s2 is equal to 2, where s1 and s2 are two slack variables which are introduced in the constraints, and x1, x2, s1, s2 or positive. The initial basic feasible solution is x1 equal to x2 is equal to 0 and s1 equal to 5, s2 is equal to 2. Now we have the first iteration of the simplex table. Here we verify that the value of cj minus zj all are greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, I am choosing the most positive one, namely I am choosing x1 will be the entering basic variable and S1 is the leaving basis variable. So in this iteration, x1 enters the basis and s1 leaves the basis. The pivotal element is 3 and r1 is the pivotal row. So in order to move to the next iteration, we need to calculate nr1 and nr2, where nr1 is old r1 by 3 and nr2 is determined by using the formula old r2 minus 0 into nr1. Therefore, we have a second iteration of the simplex table. You can verify that the values in the cj minus zj are all not negative. If I am choosing the most positive one, namely 1 by 3, which corresponds to the variable x2. So, I select x2 will be the entering basis variable and s2 leaves the basis variable. The pivotal element is 1 and pivotal row is r2. Therefore, nr2 is equal to 2, 0, 1, 0 and nr1 is equal to 1 by 3, 1, 0, 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3. So, in this iteration, x1 enters the basis and s1 leaves the basis. The pivotal element is 3 and r1 is the pivotal row. So in order to move to the next iteration, we need to calculate nr1 and nr2, where nr1 is old r1 by 3 and nr2 is determined by using the formula old r2 minus 0 into nr1. Therefore, we have a second iteration of the simplex table. Can verify that the values in the cj minus zj are all not negative. If I am choosing the most positive one, namely 1 by 3, which corresponds to the variable x2. So, I select x2 will be the entering basis variable and s2 leaves the basis variable. The pivotal element is 1 and pivotal row is r2. Therefore, nr2 is equal to 2, 0, 1, 0 and nr1 is equal to 1 by 3, 1, 0, 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3. Now we choose r1 as the source row for generating a cut from the optimal simplex table. We have 1 by 3 is equal to 1 into x1 plus 0 into x2 plus 1 by 3 s1 minus 2 by 3 s2. We express each coefficients as sum of the integer part plus positive fractional part. Therefore, the above equation can be written as 0 plus 1 by 3 is equal to 1 plus 0 x1 plus 0 plus 1 by 3 s1 plus minus 1 plus 1 by 3 s2. Now, taking all integer part to the left hand side, we have 1 by 3 plus minus x1 plus s2 is equal to 1 by 3 s1 plus 1 by 3 s2. Then, by removing the integer part, we get 1 by 3 less than or equal to 1 by 3 s1 plus 1 by 3 s2. This is called Gomori's cut. Now, by adding equation 1 at the bottom of the optimal simplex table, we get a new simplex table which is shown in iteration 4. Now, by using dual simplex method, we select x1 as the entering basis variable using the formula minimum of cj minus zj by y3j, for which y3j is strictly less than 0. And sg1 is the leaving basis variable. Here the pivotal element is minus 1 by 3 and r3 is the pivotal row, where nr1 and nr2, nr3 are calculated by as usual. In this fifth iteration, all cj minus zj less than or equal to 0, and so we obtain the optimal integer solution. Therefore, we stop the iteration and conclude that the optimal integer solution of the given problem is maximize z equal to 2 when x1 equal to 0 and x2 equal to 2. Thank you, students.